Hello students, welcome to the lecture on self-development, and after this lecture we will be able to learn the following objectives. Define self-awareness, describe the personality traits, explain intrapersonal facet of personality development, understand interpersonal facet of personality development. Let's start with a brief introduction to self-development. Self-development is taking personal responsibility for one's own learning and development through a process of assessment, reflection, and taking action. Personality self-development is an integrative process within the dynamics of a human being's evolvement. Its core and nucleus, which is characterized by personal agency to continuously enrich one's subjective experience, values, and motives in accordance with self-conception, one's own life strategy, and in harmony with her or his social environment. Personality self-development is a social and personal phenomenon and can be defined as socially valuable and personally meaningful process, a unity of antinomies, spiritual and practical, dynamic and steady, implicit internal decision to self-develop, and explicit motivation to influence the world and to actively engage in reaching the result. Creative and routine, discrete and continuing, autonomous and pedagogically supported. The role of the individual in her or his own development has been advocated strongly throughout the history of public thinking. The idea of man as author of her himself is rooted in philosophy. Socrates considered the human capability to self-improve as a major motivation of human nature. Immanuel Kant spoke of personality as an ever-changing and flowing substance that produces changes in self as a result of her or his own choice and efforts. Bourdieu held that a man is a creature who is always trying to overcome his or her limit by self-developing. Self-development is often viewed as a way to locate personal existentiality and freedom. Personality self-development can also be viewed in the context of the human developmental process in general, which includes multidimensional, physical, intellectual, moral, aesthetic vectors of human development. According to various concepts of human development, vectors of movement to self-improvement can be biological, genotype predetermined, social, formation of an individual within societal norms, rules and expectations, and subjective volition. Let us now discuss self-awareness. Self-awareness is having a clear perception of our personality, including strengths, weaknesses, thoughts, beliefs, motivation, and emotions. Self-awareness allows understanding other people, how they perceive our attitude and responses to them in the moment. It is helpful to have a relative scale for awareness. If we have ever been in an auto accident, we may have experienced everything happening in slow motion and noticing details of thought process and the event. This is a state of heightened awareness. With practice, we can learn to engage these types of heightened states and see new opportunities for interpretations in our thoughts, emotions, and conversations. Why develop self-awareness? As we develop self-awareness, we are able to make changes in the thoughts and interpretations make in mind. Changing the interpretations in mind allows changing emotions. Self-awareness is one of the attributes of emotional intelligence and an important factor in achieving success. Self-awareness is the first step in creating what we want. where we focus attention, emotions, reactions, personality, and behavior determines where we go in life. Having self-awareness allows us to see where thoughts and emotions are taking us. It also allows seeing the control of emotions, behavior, and personality so we can make changes we want. Until we are aware in the moment of the controls to thoughts, emotions, words, and behavior, we will have difficulty making changes in the direction of life. Self-awareness in relationships. Relationships are easy until there is emotional turmoil. This is the same whether they are at work or in the personal life. When we can change the interpretations in our mind of what we think, we can change emotions and shift the emotion quality of relationships. Having a clear understanding of thought and behavior patterns helps us understand other people. This ability to empathize facilitates better personal and professional relationships. Develop self-awareness. Self-awareness is developed through practices in focusing attention on the details of personality and behavior. It is not learned from reading a book. When we read a book, we are focusing attention on the conceptual ideas in the book. With attention in a book, we are practicing, not paying attention to our own behavior, emotions, and personality. Think of learning to be mindful and self-aware as learning to dance. When learning to dance, we have to pay attention to how and where our feet move, our hands and body motion, what our partner is doing, music, beat, floor space, and other dancers. Self-awareness is not learned from books, and the tango is not either. If we have an emotional reaction of anger or frustration, we notice many of the thoughts and small triggers that build up towards those emotions. We also notice moments when we can change the interpretations in mind or not believe what we are thinking. In this heightened awareness, we instinctively make better choices in thought process long before an emotional reaction or destructive behavior. Now, moving on to the next topic, we will study the personality traits. Personality researchers have proposed that there are five basic dimensions of personality. Today, many contemporary personality psychologists believe that there are five basic dimensions of personality, often referred to as the Big Five, personality traits. Trait theorists have suggested a various number of possible traits, including Gordon Allport's list of 4,000 personality traits, Raymond Cattell's 16 personality factors, and Hans Jenisek's three-factor theory. However, many researchers felt that Cattell's theory was too complex and Jenisek's was too limited in scope. As a result, the five-factor theory emerged to describe the basic traits that serve as the building blocks of personality. Today, many researchers believe that there are five core personality traits. Evidence of this theory has been growing over the past 50 years, beginning with the research of D.W. Fiske and later expanded upon by other researchers including Norman, Smith, Goldberg, and McCrae and Cost. The Big Five are broad categories of personality traits. While there is a significant body of literature supporting this five-factor model of personality, researchers do not always agree on the exact labels for each dimension. However, these five categories are usually described as extraversion. This trait includes characteristics such as excitability, sociability, talkativeness, assertiveness, and high amounts of emotional expressiveness. Agreeableness. This personality dimension includes attributes such as trust, altruism, kindness, affection, and other prosaically behaviors. Conscientiousness. Common features of this dimension include high levels of thoughtfulness with good impulse control and goal-oriented behaviors. Those high in conscientiousness tend to be organized and mindful of details. Neuroticism. The individuals high in this trait tend to experience emotional instability, anxiety, moodiness, irritability, and sadness. Openness. This trait features characteristics such as imagination and insight, and those high in this trait also tend to have a broad range of interests.
Personality. It is what makes people different and shapes how we relate to each other. There are many factors or traits involved in personality, but we will concentrate on five traits that best describe people across cultures. They are openness, conscientiousness, extroversion, agreeableness, and neuroticism. Together, these are known as the Big Five. The traits can be generally described in the following ways. Openness, appreciation for art, emotion, adventure, and unusual ideas. Imaginative and curious. Conscientiousness, a tendency to show self-discipline, act dutifully, and aim for achievement. Extroversion, energy, surgency, and the tendency to seek stimulation and the company of others. Agreeableness, a tendency to be compassionate and cooperative rather than suspicious and antagonistic towards others. Neuroticism, a tendency to easily experience unpleasant emotions such as anxiety, anger, or depression. Before getting too far into the Big Five trait theory, let's look at some of the history behind personality theory. In 1937, Gordon Allport wrote the influential book, Personality. In this book, he developed his ideas about traits, viewing these as the basic structural elements of personality. Along with H.S. Olbert, he extracted 18,000 personality-describing words from dictionaries. From this gigantic list, they extracted 4,500 personality-describing adjectives, which they considered to describe observable and relatively permanent traits. In 1946, through a series of steps, Raymond Cattell generated 16 factors, which today construct the popular 16PF personality questionnaire. The result was the hypothesis that individuals describe themselves and each other according to 16 different independent factors. Then, in 1963, W.T. Norman replicated Cattell's work and suggested that 5 factors would be sufficient. Now back to the Big Five. Each of the following traits will include photos of people who fit into both extremes of each trait. Openness, or openness to experience, describes a dimension of cognitive style that distinguishes imaginative, creative people from down-to-earth, conventional people. Open people are intellectually curious, appreciative of art, and sensitive to beauty. They tend to be compared to closed people, more aware of their feelings. People with low scores on openness to experience tend to have narrow common interests. They may regard the arts and sciences with suspicion, regarding these endeavors as abstruse or of no practical use. Closed people prefer familiarity over novelty. They are conservative and resistant to change. The intellectual style of the open person may serve a professor well. But research has shown that closed thinking is related to superior job performance in police work, sales, and a number of service occupations. Conscientiousness concerns the way in which we control, regulate, and direct our impulses. Impulses are not inherently bad. Also, in times of play rather than work, acting spontaneously and impulsively can be fun. Impulsive individuals can be seen by others as colorful, fun to be with, and even zany. The benefits of high conscientiousness are obvious. Conscientious individuals avoid trouble and achieve high levels of success through purposeful planning and persistence. On the negative side, they can be compulsive perfectionists and workaholics. Unconscientious people may be criticized for their unreliability and failure to stay within the lines, but they will experience many short-lived pleasures and they will never be called stuffy. Extroversion is marked by pronounced engagement with the external world. Extroverts enjoy being with people, are full of energy, and often experience positive emotions. They tend to be enthusiastic, action-oriented individuals who are likely to say yes or let's go to opportunity for excitement. Introverts lack the exuberance, energy, and activity levels of extroverts. They tend to be quiet, low-key, deliberate, and disengaged from the social world. Their lack of social involvement should not be interpreted as shyness or depression. The introvert simply needs less stimulation than an extrovert and prefers to be alone. Agreeableness reflects individuals' differences in concern with cooperation and social harmony. Agreeable individuals value getting along with others. They are therefore considerate, friendly, and generous, helpful and willing to compromise their interests with others. Agreeable people also have an optimistic view of human nature. Disagreeable people place self-interest above getting along with others. They are generally unconcerned with others' well-being and therefore are unlikely to extend themselves for other people. Sometimes their skepticism about others' motives causes them to be suspicious, unfriendly, and uncooperative. Disagreeable people can make excellent scientists, critics, or soldiers. Neuroticism refers to the tendency to experience negative feelings. Those who score high on neuroticism may experience primarily one specific negative feeling, such as anxiety, anger, or depression, but are likely to experience several of these emotions. People high in neuroticism are emotionally reactive. They respond emotionally to events that would not affect most people, and their reactions tend to be more intense than normal. At the other end of the scale, individuals who score low in neuroticism are less easily upset and are less emotionally reactive. They tend to be calm, emotionally stable, and free from persistent negative feelings.
Let's know the meaning of intrapersonal facet of personality development. A highly developed self-knowledge involving accurate knowledge of goals, strengths, limitations, moods, anxieties, desires, and motivations. The ability to act on the basis of this self-knowledge. Very few of us will have been taught the importance of developing interpersonal skills for the ability to reflect and monitor own progress, thoughts and feelings, strengths and weaknesses are not encouraged in educations. Indeed, education has its own formal tests that we must attend to. Those few who do possess intrapersonal intelligence have often acquired it for themselves by taking an active interest in their ability to control their own destiny. The following skills are those typically characteristic of individuals with intrapersonal intelligence. Such individuals are likely to be skilled at one or more of the following: personal efficacy, a strong awareness of one's own thoughts, strengths, and needs in order to plan effectively to achieve personal goals. Interpersonal skills, the ability to get on well with other people as well as enjoying one's own company. If we have the ability to self-reflect, we are able to recognize and change one's behaviors, build upon our strengths, and improve upon our weaknesses, resulting in very rapid development and goal-oriented achievements. Characteristics: aware of your own strengths and weaknesses, usually well-motivated and determined, possessing a strong sense of identity and purpose, probably prefers to work alone and may appear shy. Reflective thinker, may appear to be a daydreamer, a goal setter. Developing intrapersonal intelligence. Keep a diary, focusing on feelings. Set ourselves daily achievement targets. Consider what things or people cause you stress and the strategies you employ to minimize the effect. To help you become more aware of your own feelings, take a break during the day to sit quietly and reflect on the past few hours, events, and the impact that they had on you. Develop intrapersonal intelligence. Intrapersonal intelligence is the ability to reflect and access one's inner feelings. There is a strong ability to learn from past events because people exhibiting these trends analyze and interpret events that have affected them well. Ways in which individuals can improve or develop intrapersonal intelligence include the following. Learn to meditate or just set aside quiet time alone to think. Study philosophy, especially the different schools of thought from different cultures. Find a counselor or therapist and explore. Create own personal ritual that makes feel good as often as one chooses to. Record and analyze dreams, read self-help books and listen to tapes. Establish a quiet place in home for introspection. Develop an interest or hobby that sets apart from the crowd. Make a personal development plan. Set short and long-term goals and then follow through on them. Attend a course designed to help us explore ourselves and potential. Keep a daily journal for recording thoughts, dreams, goals, feelings, and memories. Study the biographies of great individuals with powerful personalities who made a real impact on the world. Do something to spoil at least once a day. Keep a mirror handy and notice how one's face changes depending on what kind of mood we are in. Spend time with people who have a strong and healthy sense of self. Engage in daily self-esteem, enhancing behaviors such as listing successes, positive self-talk, and so on. Write your own autobiography. Interpersonal facet of personality development. Interpersonal development helps organizational leaders to achieve instrumental goals that further the agenda of the firm. According to social scientists, there are four distinct stages a person passes through en route to improving communication with others. The first is beginning awareness, in which the subject learns that a better way to behave will help achieve more effective results. This is followed by the second stage, awkwardness, in which the initial forays at implementing new behaviors, skills are not as honed or refined as one would like, and mistakes are more common. The third stage, skillfulness, marks the time when the subject is proficient in implementation and achieves success in expression with satisfactory results, but needs to conduct considerable planning and real-time thinking in order to execute. Finally, after further practice, one arrives at the fourth stage called integration. This level is achieved when appropriate automatic reactions take place without conscious intervention on the part of the performer. The key to achieving the fourth stage of behavioral proficiency occurs when the subject understands the concept of cognitive complexity, defined as the ability to understand a plethora of different angles for examining an issue or putting ourselves in the other person's shoes. Interpersonal traits, measured in the Winslow assessment. Sociability, extroverted, outgoing, friendly, gregarious, neighborly, congenial, warm-hearted individuals who enjoy interacting and participating with others. They greet strangers openly, are quick to form friendships, and enjoy careers dealing with people rather than things. They are rarely content in solitary work. Recognition. Proper cooperative, courteous, accommodating, considerate, polite, respectful. Have a strong desire to be viewed as a socially desirable person by friends, co-workers, and others. Try to do things correctly and meet the expectations of others. Want their accomplishments to be recognized and rewarded. Conscientious. Dependable, loyal, ethical, honorable, trustworthy, dutiful, faithful, moralistic. Place the desires and welfare of others before their own personal preferences. Willing to do things according to rules. Will not attempt to bend the rules to suit their personal needs. Will not attempt to take advantage of others. Could be inflexible. Exhibition. Exhibitionist. Entertaining, demonstrative, expressive, flamboyant, colorful, dramatic. Have a strong desire to be the center of attention and to have an audience. Will use words, actions, and possessions to draw attention to themselves. Sometimes this behavior can be inappropriate or overwhelming depending upon the timing and tact. Trust. Open, confiding, trusting, unsuspicious, believing, tolerant, ready to forget difficulties, naive, exceptionally trusting individuals who readily accept others for who they are. Believe what others say, are free of jealous tendencies, and tend to get along well with most people. Pliant to changes, could be gullible. Nurturance. Compassionate, sympathetic, kind-hearted, benevolent, caring, protective, and charitable. Very nurturing individuals who provide compassion and support to others. Readily communicate their concern for the well-being of others and express their willingness to do whatever they can to assist others. May take on the problems of others inappropriately. Now, in the end, let us summarize what we have learned in this lecture. Self-development. It is taking personal responsibility for one's own learning and development through a process of assessment, reflection, and taking action. Self-awareness is having a clear perception of personality, including strengths, weaknesses, thoughts, beliefs, motivation, and emotions. Relationships are easy until there is emotional turmoil. This is the same whether they are at work or in their personal life. A highly developed self-knowledge involving accurate knowledge of goals, strengths, limitations, moods, anxieties, desires, and motivations. Interpersonal development helps organizational leaders to achieve instrumental goals that further the agenda of the firm. Personal efficacy. A strong awareness of one's own strengths, weaknesses, and needs in order to plan effectively to achieve personal goals.